Hello, this is going to be a short video, hopefully short, about the new BodyPack PA system. And I'm not going to play it very loud because I've got neighbours. Okay, so here it is. Weighs about 2.5 kilos. It's about 33 centimeters that way, 30 centimeters that way, and about 7 centimeters thick. And it's based on the standard MK2.5 PA system mine. You'll see that on the website as well. It's got all the same electronics as that. There are two speaker options. Neither of them are the same as the 2.5. This one's a slightly lighter weight one, and then there's an alternative which is slightly heavier but slightly more powerful. So it depends on whether weight or power your primary requirements. And I'm powering it today from this the Q thing, which you'll also find on the website. And I just taped on there a little button for it, a little remote control activated button. Of course, with that and with this, sensors over your body, magnetic sensors, tilt sensors, press button sensors. You could make yourself into a musical instrument if you wanted to, or a whole soundscape, anything you really want with audio. You could have buttons all over yourself, and then all the audio coming out of this, which is amazing. This differs from a lot of the other PAs, and then we've got a microphone input on this one as well. So, in the video coming up, you'll see three microphones being used. I just want to do another little piece about this little chap, which is a power supply for an Electret microphone. So here's an Electret microphone. This is a T-Bone. This is in the video as well. This is a T-Bone ear mic from Thomann, and it's designed for Sennheiser radio mic. So that goes there. Plug him in there, turn him on. Put it in the high gain input, which is this red one here. This is the volume control, gain control for that input. And then this is a master gain for both. Give him a go out there. Turn it on. And hopefully there's not too much feedback. You can hear, just about hear that coming through already. And turn it up a bit, turn it up a bit, bit more. There we go, and you can hear that that works quite well. And there's plenty of power there, which I'm not going to explore here. That's quite a handy thing. That's a Stageline EMA20. There's also a little one you can get with, it comes with a microphone. This one doesn't come with a microphone, but there's another one that does. Search around the internet. This is the one that's coming up in the video as well. Very similar thing. 1.5 volt power supply from Electret. And this is the microphone. Another microphone that was in the video. On the back here we have battery level meter. So turn it on, press the little red button, and that tells you how many bars of battery you've got left. You've got 4 out of 5 there. Blue LED light, power light, and like all the PAs, that flashes when it overloads, when it enters clipping. So clipping is about distortion. So when that starts flashing, you playing it a bit too loud, but it gives you a good indication for where to set maximum volume. Fuse here, this is recharge socket, but also power in, power out. You can power USB stuff from this, optional extra stuff going on there. And this is for an external speaker, so the ideal thing to connect up to this would be an MK2.5 thing. Out here. So that's just a standard 2.5 thing connected onto there. And then you've got a stereo PA system, which you could use for static work. Then you could use this on its own for a walkabout, so it's a super flexible system. And of course, I mean, if you wanted to, you could have somebody hold, you could do walkabout, you know, someone could be holding this and could make you up a fancy magnetic linked cable, so you could hold hands and you'd have two speakers, one for each person, then you could separate and go your own ways and come back together. I'm happy to talk about custom specifications for anybody who's interested. There we go. There'll be another bit of video coming along soon. Okay, cheers, thanks for watching.
Rocco's on here. And then things tighten up. There's a slightly temperamental MP3 player. Hopefully it'll behave itself.
Mic function as well. I'm just going to try three different mics out. And we've got an extra mic gain setting on here. So there you go, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. We'll just turn that up to about there, and that to about there. And you can tell. I mean, we can get some feedback if we really want to. But you have to work at it a bit. I mean, there's no feedback currently. And then this is a Shure. It's just a standard SM58 mic. And if we point it at the PA, then we will get feedback.
But in normal circumstances, you're not going to be doing that, so it's not a problem. And then we'll just turn it up to full, just so you get an idea of, you know, the kind of volume if you're in a crowded space. And of course, you've got the second input where you can have music playing at the same time. We'll just turn it down a little bit, so you can have a background track playing. And we're going to put two other mics in, just so you can see what they're like. This is a little... This is a little Electret microphone, just set the levels. This is a little Electret power supply here. I'll just turn it off and see if it goes away. It's just got a little button cell battery inside there that's powering it. So we'll just get that set about right. Maybe something near there. Anyway, you get the idea. If this was clipped onto your lapel, as it's kind of designed to do, then it's not going to be any good. Because you're not going to hear anything over there. So there are ways of using this kind of mic, but not kind of quite how it's intended, but it's still potentially very useful with this. And the feedback points are thus. So it's, again, it's not overly sensitive, so you can get away with using that for lots of different things. And then I'm going to use a T-Bone ear mic designed for Sennheiser radio mic system. So again, I'm just going to set the levels appropriate for this. Maybe 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. It's a little bit more sensitive on feedback. If I was to bend forward, you can hear there's a bit of feedback there. Properly set up though would work fine, and the closer the mic is to your mouth the better, really. And with this sort of mic, whenever I was performing with it or my friend was performing, we'd have a bit of tape to hold it on the cheek really close, and then it would come quite kind of invisible. So all those mics have slightly different sound qualities, different feedback qualities, different applications. But to be able to walk about, kind of hands-free maybe, with your own amplified voice, is useful for a lot of situations for performers. And as I said, you can have your background music playing as well at the same time. Or if you wanted to, you could go the whole hog and have a cue thing plugged in here and have body switches all over you to send off sounds of all different types. And you've got the output speaker to attach a normal kind of thing as a secondary speaker if you wanted to. All kinds of options for lots of different environments and situations and custom applications. Okay, thank you for watching. Cheers. Bye.